Right, so we've let our bond cure overnight. Our bros are really secure onto the hatch cover, ready to take some serious pounding in the surf and on the shore break. You can see how nice and flexible our flexi bro is. And today we're going to spend some time spitting and polishing our boards to get that shine out of all our hard work. Right, so we're at that place now where we've done just about everything we can. It's really down to the final sanding and polishing of the boards. If you remember previously, I sanded the main running surface of the board before I fitted my water pipes. So the rest of the sanding now is really going to be cosmetic in essence, but it still needs to be done properly. What we don't want to do in this process is break through this clear layer that we gave the board. Otherwise we're going to have to start over again by applying another layer of clear, letting that dry and harden, and then sand it again. So this process is really just about removing as little of the clear layer as possible, but bringing out that lovely shine, that smooth shine and luster to the board. So what we need for that, start over with a little mini sander, with 120 grit on it, and we just give the board a light sand, just removing any little high spots. We use our blade, as we spoke previously, to remove the tape line around the rail of the board. I use a little scotch guard inside the housing area just to wipe out the wax, because that kind of gets a little bit grimy. Then I have a selection of water paper here, ranging from 150, 360, 400, 600, 800, 1000 and 1200, which I'll use in a process in sanding the board, bringing it up to the 1200 grit water paper, but after which I can then start polishing it. Without further ado, let's get started. What I like to do on the small high spots is just take the blade, just flatten it down. It just isolates the area. Because sometimes if you try and sand a little high spot down, you could end up sanding around that high spot and going through your clear resin. So just in the initial stages, just use your blade to remove unnecessary high spots. So with the 150 cloth, all I'm doing is just removing any of the high spots. Cut them off. So we're just using the blade here to reduce this little step that we had our tape. Right, so that's the best part of the dry sanding done. We're just now going to go through a process of water papering from 360 grit through to 1200 and get these boards looking really shiny and smooth. Right, I'm onto the 600 grit cloth now. And just to say, when you're sanding with water paper, just try to keep some type of uniformity when you're sanding. You have a pattern that you work through, so you have a beginning and an end on the board. Otherwise you find yourself sanding all over the show and you kind of lose sight of where you're at. So start in a particular place, like I do the top from nose to tail, and then I do my rails. So have a pattern, a certain amount on either side, work your way through. Okay. Right, after plenty of elbow grease, we're on our sixth change out of sandpaper. We're on our 1200 grit here. Our final water papering before we start polishing. And you can start seeing the shine of this board come alive. Phew! So there we have the board sanded, six variances of cloth, got them down nice and smooth, flat. Now we're just going to set to work with a fiberglass polishing paste, loaded with some elbow grease, and we're going to bring these boards up to an awesome high gloss shine. There we have our gloss finish. Board shining. That authentic glass over foam look.